Hello and welcome to the third development entry for Katie and Betty. A lot happened in the past 2 weeks once again, so let's jump right in. The first thing that I did was the dialogue text is more stable now. It doesn't jump around anymore. Basically what I did was I displayed the text completely with a white font on white background and just go through each letter and turn it black. So now even when the dialogue sentence is a bit longer than the speech bubble, it wraps nicely from the beginning, which is nice. I also fixed camera ratio and resolution issues. Basically, when you resize the game, I wanted to make sure that everything is within the borders, of course. I actually found a script on gamedesigntheory.blogspot.com. And I turned it into a prefab, and then I had to insert that camera prefab into every one of the 60 scenes or so. That was nice. But it's fixed now. I updated the movement of Katy and Betty to use add force instead of translate. I wanted to fix the jittering when running against colliders. There are some colliders, for example, the heart vines. You cannot cross the heart vines, so whenever you bump into them, you get stopped. And I was using force-mode.impulse for this, but I mean, I got some good results, but then I reverted back to using translate because it always felt slightly off. And I'm really not sure what the issue was, but it just wasn't smooth enough. Instead, I'm now checking for collisions using overlap circle non-allocate. And then I reset the position whenever something gets hit. There were a few days where I was really unhappy with the movement of the game and it sort of turned me off working on it. It was really important to fix the movement in general again so that it feels good again to work on it. Yeah. Anyway, let's have a look at some of the features that I implemented. The first thing that I added was the two-player support on one keyboard. Basically, player 1 plays on the left side of the keyboard and player 2 can play on the numpad area of the keyboard. It's a bit awkward, but if you only have one keyboard to play together, I think it's going to work. I still recommend playing with two controllers, if possible. I also finally upgraded to Unity 2020. I removed all of the Playmaker scripts and was able to upgrade it without issues this time. Well, it still took a few hours in total, but the updated editor was definitely worth the effort, so I'm glad that this is over. It has dark mode now, which is nice. On the overworld, I implemented the paw prints. Finally, I've been looking forward to this for a long time now, and I actually posted a quick look at how I created them on my Twitter profile. So please follow me on Twitter. I drew and implemented the level complete pop-up. This required a bunch of animations that get tied together with code. It still needs actual real data to display. The total amount of boxes that you've placed and the total amount of time that you spent playing the level. But so far I'm really happy with how it turned out. And I hope you agree. For the spirits, whenever they march into a gate, I wanted to add a certain effect, and I drew and implemented lines and butterflies for this. And the butterfly that flies away when the last spirit enters the gate is actually the same code from my Broken Heaven video. If you want, you can check it out. I'm linking it in the description. Next, I wanted to make the flame of the spirits, like the top of the spirit sprite, bend depending on the movement. So I actually started looking into shaders. My first try was with a vertex shader, which looked a little strange, probably because of the mesh. I probably could have made a custom mesh for the sprites, but I found an interesting tutorial that worked with fragment shaders, so I tried this. And that turned out quite well, and I think it's really lovely. The tutorials that I used to understand shaders were by Freya Holmer and Quill18Creates. I will also link these in the description if you want to check them out yourself. Then, of course, I continued building the levels. I built level 27, which is more or less a side story. Then I created level 28. It's basically a hidden path that you have to unveil with your spirits. Actually, with these two levels added, I now have all the levels that I wanted to have. There are 30 levels in total now, and I can basically play from beginning to end. So now the real fun begins. I can actually focus on adding details and, you know, polish everything. It's really important that the basic outline of the game is now done, so I can spice everything up a little bit. So what's next? I definitely want to work on the splash screen, because I can also use it as a logo for store images and things like that. The current image on itch.io is a temporary one, even though I think it's really cute. I also want to implement the clouds on the overworld. It's basically a fork of war, but you know, there's no war in Catty and Patty, so. And I also want to add options, which is going to be a bit similar to the start menu. It's going to involve another character from Catty and Patty, and I think it's going to be nice. Of course, I also want to start actually adding sounds and music, and there's going to be a lot of beta testing that needs to be done, and I'm looking forward to that. And that's it. Remember, you can get early access on itch.io or by becoming a Patreon. And as always, thank you for watching, and I hope I will see you next time. Bye bye.